Hello friends, so today we are gonna see a problem based on Laplace transform of standard function, and here we are gonna solve the given problem and we are gonna find out the Laplace transform of cos of omega t plus alpha. So how to find the Laplace of cos of omega t plus alpha? Now let's see the formula which is available for or the formula to find out the Laplace transform of cos of at. So what is the formula? The formula to find out Laplace of cos at is s upon s square plus a square. Now if you'll see, then in the formula we have cos at, whereas here we have cos omega t plus alpha. It means I have an extra term plus alpha, and since I have an extra term plus alpha, I cannot use this formula directly, because this formula is applicable if and only if I have at with cos. So it means I want to expand this term and reduce it in such a way that I can apply the formula in this form, that is cos of at. So for that, what I'll do is, here cos omega t plus alpha, I'll expand it by using the formula cos a plus b. So what is the formula of cos of a plus b? So it is cos a cos b minus sin a sin b. So now here omega t is a and alpha is b. So therefore I'll say, consider cos of omega t plus alpha. So by this formula we will get cos of omega t, that is cos of a, into cos of alpha, that is cos of b, minus sine of omega t, that is sine a, and sine of alpha, that is sine b. So now I got the expansion of cos of omega t plus alpha. So I'll substitute this value in the question. So therefore the Laplace transform of cos of omega t plus alpha is nothing but Laplace transform of cos of omega t into cos alpha minus sine of omega t into sine alpha. Now here I was having the one term, but now due to the formula, now I got the two terms. So I'll separate the two terms and apply the Laplace transform separately. So here we'll get Laplace of cos of omega t into cos of alpha minus Laplace of sine of omega t into sine of alpha. Now let's find out the value of first term. So we know that we use Laplace transform to transform the function of t into function of s. Now here if you'll observe the bracket, then we have two functions. One is cos omega t and other is cos alpha. Now if you'll see the cos alpha, then that term does not have t. It means I can say cos alpha is constant. So whenever we find the Laplace transform, that time we can take the constant term outside. Hence this cos alpha will come outside, and we need to find out Laplace of cos of omega t. And now this term has t, and we can find out Laplace transform of function of t. Hence by using the formula Laplace of cos at, we will get cos alpha as it is, and here we'll get s upon s square plus omega square, because the value of a over here is omega. So we got the value. Now let's solve the second term. So middle sign is negative. Now in second term also, if you'll see carefully, then sine alpha is constant because it does not have t term. So I can take that constant outside. So here I'll get sine alpha outside, and now I'll find out the Laplace of sine omega t. So minus sine again as it is, sine alpha as it is. Now how to get Laplace of sine omega t? So my friends, we have a direct formula to find out the Laplace of sine at. So what is the formula? So Laplace of sine at is given by the formula a upon s square plus a square. Now here in the problem we have a as omega. So in the answer I'll substitute a as omega. So we'll get omega upon s square plus omega square. So that is the Laplace of sine omega t. Now I'll multiply this s with cos alpha. Here I'll get s cos alpha upon s square plus omega square minus, here I'll get omega sine alpha upon s square plus omega square. Now I can take the both denominators together since they are same, and here I'll get s square plus omega square in the denominator, and in numerator will get s cos alpha minus omega sine alpha. And my friends, that is the value of Laplace of cos of omega t plus alpha, which we got by using the standard expansion of Laplace transform. Thank you.